Australian mathematics curriculum. Simplifying by multiplying and dividing pronumerals. We've already learned how to simplify an algebraic expression by gathering like terms, that is, adding and subtracting any like terms within the expression. But we might be asked to multiply or divide. Unlike adding and subtracting, we don't need to have like terms when we're multiplying and dividing pronumerals. We can multiply and divide any algebraic term with any other one. We're going to start by multiplying. When we're multiplying algebraic terms, we first multiply all the coefficients, then we multiply the pronumerals. So we have a look at an example. 3a times 2b times 4a. Now I'll add an extra line of working in here just to show you why this works. 3a is 3 times a times 2b, which is 2 times b, times 4a, 4 times a. We know that we can multiply in any order. So the first line of working I'd actually want is we rearrange the order so all the numbers, coefficients, are together. 3 times 2 times 4. Then we rearrange our remaining pronumerals so that we've grouped the same letters. Times A times B. I would put this line of working in here, but I wouldn't worry about the previous lines, just to show you how that works. 3 times 2 is 6, 6 times 4, 24. A times A is A squared, and B. No times signs because, of course, we're down to an algebraic term now and we don't use times signs. Another example, 2m multiplied by negative 4m. Multiply our coefficients, 2 times negative 4, and multiply our pronumerals, m times m. One line of working to show what we're doing. 2 times negative 4 is negative 8, remembering a positive times a negative gives us a negative. M times m is m squared, and we don't need our multiplication sign. Our answer is negative 8m squared. If we're dividing, it's always easiest and best to rewrite our division as a fraction. So here I've got negative 6x over 2. Once we've got it as a fraction, we follow the normal rules for simplifying a fraction. That is, we find the highest value, the highest number, or the highest term that can go evenly into the top and the bottom. That is, finding the highest common factor. The highest common factor of negative 6x and 2 is just 2. So we're going to cancel out the common factor of 2, that is divide the top and the bottom by 2. Negative 6x divided by 2 leaves me with negative 3x. 2 divided by 2 leaves me with 1. And rewrite. On the top we have negative 3x, and because we've only got 1 on the bottom, we can get rid of that and just have negative 3x. Another example, here it's already in a fraction form, 14x over 7xy. Here, our highest common factor, we can see that we've got 7, but it's in fact 7x, because we've got 7x on the top and the bottom. 7x times 2 up the top would get us 14x, 7x times y on the bottom would get us 7xy. So we cancel out that common factor. Our x's cancel out. I'm left with 2 here and 1 here. 2 on the top, 1y on the bottom, and of course, when our coefficient is 1, we don't write it, so I've got 2 over y.